So we're finally done with that page. Let's go to the water pipe, guys. Let's cool off. Water pipes. I have no way to manipulate the pipe I want to do. I can't do anything here. Wild worm, here we come. Oh man, that worm is super wild! Eating fruits! While ants and bees move around. He's such a stealthy little bastard, isn't he? And he died. Oh, you literally play as a motherfucking worm. Oh, jeez. He freaking moved like one too, man. Holy crap. This is literally the fastest he moves. Oh shit, he's a bigger worm now. He got fat. Eating nothing but fruit all the day long. He should have had some dirt. Nice healthy dirt for worms to eat. Alright, let's check out Wonder Ball. Got 100! Woo! I don't know of any way to actually control the game. Yeah, this one's stupid. Right, man, this is really getting tiresome. Holy crap. Move box! Let me just tilt the camera a little bit. Get everything in a better shot there. Did it fucking crash? Yes, it did. It did fucking crash. Oh, now we've got an unlicensed game from way back in the day. Okay. I think I played this one before. I don't remember. Oh yeah, this is the one that's also known as Tag and Dragon. Haha. I knew that because I thought this game looked familiar. I saw it in like one of the AVGN episodes or something. If it's not Tag and Dragon, it's basically the same exact game. It's like one, not even 1 second different. But you know what? After playing all those Chinese ROM hacks, I'm kind of refreshed to see an unlicensed American game. But it's still shitty. Back Future. Let's go Back Future. Oh shit, it's a freaking LJN game. Well, I kind of figured that we'd actually be getting to real games again. Yeah, let's try it for a little bit. Everybody's favorite. But you know what? This game probably seemed like a million times better than the games we were playing in comparison. That's what's sad. Like, that's the way you could play LJN Back to the Future is get this cartridge and play the 200 fucking ROM hacks first. Then it might actually seem enjoyable. Can't even see the freaking glass. Can't do anything about Biff Hannon either. Gotta grab them clocks! Clock in it. I gotta make it to the end? Finally, holy crap, barely too. Now it's time for everybody's favorite, which is the next part of the stage. I thought the next part was gonna be the root beer thing or whatever, the diner segment of the game. When do you get the skateboard? Yeah, who cares? I never got the significance of the bottom of the screen. I know it's supposed to be like the photograph from the movie, but like I never got the significance of why certain things disappear. Oh shit, we got the bowling ball! Time to fuck some shit up with some bowling balls now. Like throw bowling balls at bumblebees, man. Talk about overkill. Woo! I still don't understand the significance of the clocks. I think it's supposed to... What killed me there? What actually killed me there? Wait, are we starting over? I think I'm done. Okay, so we knew back future. Okay, so if it seems like a real game, then it probably is. So, Arkista Ring, that's a real game. Bandai Golf. Castle, excellent, I think that is, too. The Universe... Sold? That I'm not sure about. The Universe Soldiers. Okay. I'm playing as the missile, apparently. Gotcha. It's a Pac-Man game. It's like the easiest Pac-Man game ever to exist. Yeah, that's what I think about this game. Alright, Dash Galaxy. I actually used to have a game a long time ago. Q-Bert, Egypt, that's a Japanese game. Alpha Mission, I think it's that one game that we already played. I don't remember. Or wait, no, this is an SNK game, if I'm not mistaken. The Shmup. Old school. Yep. It's not that great, but it's fine, I guess. I mean, it's a billion times better than the ROM hacks, and like a thousand times better than Back to the Future, but it's still kind of crappy, you know? I have some pretty messed up degrees of levels, you know, like, without a doubt. I like how they move in these weird patterns where they kind of don't really go after you at all. It's like, what's even the point? You know, like, this is not an obstacle. I can just sit here and... be chilling it. They don't shoot projectiles either, so I mean, I'm not concerned. Now we got something that actually attacks. Holy crap. Yeah, I'm done. Firehouse Rescue, I think it's a Fisher-Price game. I can't believe I'm hitting start on this. I just hit start. Oh, I think I... Oh, man. Oh, jeez. I actually remember a friend of mine as a kid, his little brother, I think he was like 4 years old, he had this game. Oh, man. Gotta go to the house. To save a freaking cat! Come on, you know that fucking cat? Where'd the cat go? Press to start. Okay, whatever. I can't believe we're doing this, guys. Oh, jeez. The sad thing is, I'd rather play this than the Chinese ROM hacks. Oh, shit. Oh, there's another person. Okay, let's save them too, I suppose. I mean, for the house not looking at all like any kind of trouble, like, why am I coming by to let you climb down ladders? I didn't see any fire. I can remember that's also Fisher-Price, Hokuto no Ken. Shoot, is that the Fist of the North Star? I think it is. Yep, it is. Holy crap, he exploded! Yeah, we've got a motherfucking Fist of the North Star game up in here, man. Suck it. Wait, human being. Go back, come back, come back. Gotta love how that projectile, like, perfectly curved in a manner that I could not dodge it. Oh, he can punch. Okay, well, it doesn't seem like there's any point to doing it. Why are we having to go in this direction, though, to progress? That's what I don't understand. Holy crap, these people get crazy. This game is freaking insane! Which, I mean, I guess it makes sense given the anime it's based off of, but holy crap. Oh, shit. I guess this is about as accurate as they could do back in those days. I don't even know if I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. Like, are you supposed to just go in this direction and continually jump around and kick guys or what? Fortunately, there's not a jump attack that I'm aware of, so... Yeah, we're done. Alright, we got Chitty Taken. I'm sure that's a Japanese game of some type. We'll check it out. This looks a lot like Dig Dug, actually. Is that what this is? No, this is not Dig Dug. There's no way. It's like a ripoff of Dig Dug, maybe, but it's not actual Dig Dug. Yeah. Alright, okay. There's that Destination Earth Star. That was the game I was talking about earlier. Truck Rally. Don't know what that is. Oh, Monster Truck Rally. Now, this game's actually pretty cool. Because you get a track builder, and you can build any kind of monster truck track you want. Plus, it has four players. It's So we can go ahead and make a nice little track here. Let's go ahead and do a gentle uphill, steep uphill, steep downhill. Not sure how we get back to the other way. Okay, gotcha. Yeah, we're gonna make a little course here, people. Need another turn here. Gotta get the turn the other way. There we go. Track is built. Let's race the track. This is a track we created, people. It's not gonna be very good, but it is what it is. Yeah, here we go. Here comes the steep uphill, here comes the steep downhill. Woo! Not the most exciting racing game, I can tell you that, but hey, you know what? It functions. And it's got a track editor. It's like the only NES game I know of that's not a side bike that has one. And technically, it's a little bit more in-depth than the side bike one. Although I prefer side bike, obviously, for obvious reasons, like being a better game, for example, but they did what they could. So, props to Monster Truck Rally for being one of the innovators in that segment. Got Bingo 75. 75 Bingo. It's a motherfucking slot machine. We're done here. I was at least expecting a motherfucking bingo game, but nah, I can't have that. Tengengehu Tant. Oh, it's TNC Surf Design, okay. Okay, weird Japanese name, but okay. This is actually one of the early LJA games. I know there's a way to grab the... Oh, you have to do that. That's right, okay. Yeah. But this game really is not bad. At least not this segment of the game. TNC Surf and Skate Design. Ah, we're done. Alright. Battle Tank, that's like Aladdin 3. There was no Aladdin 3. Oh, I actually played this at my friend Wolf King of Kong's house. He had this in his ROMs collection. It's just... It's this. That's all it is this. Cool. Alright, now we're starting to get back into some decent games like Tecmo Bowl and Gradius and Quarth, whatever that is. Let's find out. What? What in the flying hell is this? Is this like a Tetris shmup? I think it might be. Holy crap! It is! The Tetris shoot 'em up! Heck, music's kinda catchy too, I like it. This is interesting, man. I'm kind of liking this game. Yeah, I've never even heard of this game in my life, man. I guess you get points if you're closer to crashing or something. I don't know. Seems legit. Got a good gameplay hook, it's just not exactly a finished game. Like, there's not really that much going on here. That's the only flaw going really here. But I'm still hooked, man. It's got a good gameplay hook, like I said. Just not really a complete game. Yeah, we're done, though. Here's Mojigen. That kind of looks familiar. Yeah, maybe it doesn't. The platformer. Okay, you can break stuff. You can do like Fred Durst from Limp Bizkit. I suppose, if you really want to. Wait, are we supposed to get up there? Did I screw myself, game? Yeah, I guess you have to perfect it, man. There you go. It's a little tricky with this controller, man. Oh, well, that's fun. I wonder, actually. I never got when they use the word rest. Why did they use the word rest for representing 1-ups? I don't get that. I always made fun of that. Even when I was a little kid, I was like, I've got 2 rests left! Alright, okay, let's go mystery. It's a mystery, it doesn't tell us what it is. Mystery quest. Oh yeah, I've played this one before. It's kind of stupid, it's like a... Sort of like an Alex Kidd-ish game, I suppose. I mean, it definitely seems like Chinese ROM hack territory. That's terrible. This was 1988, so this game came out a year after games like Castlevania. Just to put things in perspective, or, you know, Mega Man. And they thought this was acceptable. But I don't know. Could be a good little gameplay hook here. Oh, that's bad. Don't step on the skulls. Okay. Apparently you can go into things. Just so doorways are always too small. Apparently I was able to walk on top of the enemy for a second there. No problem. We got 634 kin. Hells yeah. This game looks familiar. I don't know if that's a game we actually officially got or not. I don't think it is, but maybe it was. Grab the keys. Whoa! Ha ha ha! Why? Why does grabbing keys make you teleport like 5,000 feet? Oh, jeez. Oh, the sun killed me. Okay. Japanese video games, people. That's all we can need to say to explain that. Yep. I mean, watch a lot of these games that I think that are legit, like Friday the 13th, actually going to mean something else entirely. I mean, come on. It says Friday the 13th. Could it be something different? Nah, it's the right game. Let's play with everybody's favorite, Mark. I think he was a crappy one. I don't know. That's what's really weird about this game is, like, there's characters that are better than others. That's really funny, in a way, you know? Actually, I think Mark might have been one of the good ones, because he actually has a good jump. That's how you can generally tell if the character's good based on their jumping capabilities. Alright, so where's Jason at? He's way the hell off there. Let's go in this cabin real quick instead. Nothing in here. Let's switch to one of their kids, I think. Let me switch to, how do we switch to other kids? Oh, you gotta go in the big cabins, that's right, okay. Let's go this way, people. Is that the way? Yeah, that's the way you're supposed to go. The thing that sucks about the freaking woods is you can't tell where you're actually going. Grab a knife there. Yeah, I like me some Friday the 13th. Don't harp on me for it. It's a fun little game. But, it is what it is. I don't know where I'm going. I think we're lost now. That's why I hate going in the freaking woods, man. You can't ever figure out where you're supposed to go. Well, I guess one of the kids are freaking dead. Ha! Alright, boot cat. Oh, okay, it's... Yeah, okay, I know what it is now. I think it's a Japan only. I don't think we got a version of it, so... It's weird how the time is counting like that. Oh, okay. There's Hello Kitty. Why? Why'd they spell it like that, man? They can clearly see Hello Kitty, the spelling. It just copied that exactly. That doesn't seem like Lip Pull or Pull Lip. Exciting cube game. When I think of cube games, I don't think exciting. It's a Tetris game. Exactly what it is. Did I screw myself? Why can't I do anything? I do not understand. D block. It's a real game. This is a weird ass game, dude. Really, I'm not understanding, man. Like you're building a giant space station of Tetris blocks or something, I don't know, man. Yeah, it's kind of dumbsy, isn't it? Yeah, that's D block for you.